قرآن می‌فرماد ما بنی اسرائیل را از دریا گذراندیم، یونس آیات 90 و 92. فرعون و لشکریانش به قصد ستم و تعدی به تعقیبشان پرداختند. چون فرعون غرق می‌شد گفت ایمان آوردم، که هیچ خدایی جز آن که بنی اسرائیل بدان ایمان آوردن نیست. قرآن خیلی قشنگ فهمید، گفت و انا من المسلمین، و من از تسلیم شدگانم. الان خدا میفهمه حالا که داری غرق میشی دیگه دوغه رو نمیاد. و قد عصیت قبلو، تو پیش از این عصیان میکردی و از مفسدان بودی، امروز جسم تو را به بلندی میافکنیم تا برای آنان که پس از تو میمانند عبرتی باشد، با حال آنکه بسیاری از مردم از آیات ما غافلند. چون بعدا میدونید که این جنازه فرعون پیدا شد، این که قرآن میفهمه ما اینو میذاریم نشونه برای آیندگان، پیدا شد و توی تحقیقاتی که کردن رو جسمش نمکی درش پیدا شد که اون نمک به آب همون دریای اونجا میخورد. یکی از همین دانشمندان غربی فکر کنم مثلا فرانسوی، موریس بوکای، ایشون با همین آیه، یکی از آیاتی که دلیل شد مسلمان بشه همین آیه بود.
In the town of Pont-l'Évêque in the French Basse-Normandie region, Maurice Bocaille was born on French Christian parents in July 19, 1920. After his secondary education at a Catholic school, he joined the Faculty of Medicine at French University. He joined at an early stage in his life the famed French Society of Egyptology, where he studied hieroglyphics. In 1981, Francis Mitterrand, the president of France, requested from the Egyptian government to allow France to host the mummy of Pharaoh to run laboratory and archaeological examination on the mummy. The scientists were headed by Professor Maurice Bocaille. Scientists were trying to restore the mummy, while Professor Maurice was mainly concerned with how did the mummy had died. The final report of the scientists stated that the remaining salt in the mummy was overt evidence that the person had drowned in the sea, and the body was rescued very shortly where it was immediately embalmed to be preserved. Professor Maurice wrote his final report on it. However, someone whispered to him that Muslims claim to know something about the drowning of this mummy. He was told that Muslims believe in a book called the Quran, and this Quran narrates the story of Pharaoh's drowning and ensures the safety of his body after his death as to be assigned to mankind. Although he denied such things at that time, the professor sat down pondering on what he was told about the Book of Muslims, while his holy book narrates only the drowning of Pharaoh without saying anything about his body. Then he decided to pack his baggage and travel to Saudi Arabia, where a medical conference happened to be held with a galaxy of Muslim anatomists attending. He spoke to them about his discovery of the mummy and what great shape this mummy was in after drowning in the sea. One of the Muslim scientists stood up and simply opened the Quran and pointed out to the professor this verse: Pharaoh's body was kept intact even after he drowned. One of the other participants opened the Quran and read out the verse in which Allah Almighty said, فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةٌ وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا لَغَافِلُونَ. It is said that in his excitement he stood before the attendants and loudly said, I have converted to Islam and I believe in this Quran. Then he went back to France with a totally different demeanor than when he had arrived. In France, he dedicated 10 years investigating the scientific discoveries and comparing them with the Quran and trying to come up with one scientific contradiction with the Quran. Finally, he quoted one verse from the Quran to be his conclusion: no falsehood can approach it from before or behind it. It is sent down by one full of wisdom, worthy of all praise.